वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. वेलकम बैक टू क्लास 6 कंप्यूटर साइंस. एंड इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ टैग्स, व्हाट इज टैग, एट्रीब्यूट्स, वैल्यूज. एंड देन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ टैग्स लाइक व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन एम्प्टी टैग एंड अ कंटेनर टैग. नाउ टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट सम ऑफ द बेसिक टैग्स, बेसिक एचटीएमएल टैग्स व्हिच आर जनरली यूज्ड इन एचटीएमएल डॉक्यूमेंट. ओके, एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी रिटेन द बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एन एचटीएमएल डॉक्यूमेंट वेयर यू हैव सीन द टैग्स लाइक एचटीएमएल टैग, हेड टैग, टाइटल टैग एंड द बॉडी टैग इज बीन इंक्लूडेड इन ऑल द एचटीएमएल डॉक्यूमेंट. सो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट देम वन बाय वन दैट व्हाट इज द पर्पस ऑफ यूजिंग ऑल दिस tags in each and every HTML document and why it is necessary to you. So we will start with beginning and end of HTML document. Mark the beginning and end of an HTML document. Okay, its purpose, the purpose of using the HTML tag in our HTML document is just for marking the beginning and the end. Okay, when the interpreter starts converting or interpreting the high level language, as HTML is a high level language, into machine code, or when the instruction is given to the web browser, so by seeing the HTML tag, the web browser comes to know that it has to deal with an HTML document. So the purpose of using the HTML document in HTML tag in any HTML document is just for marking the beginning and the end of the HTML document. Just it is used to mark that from here the document is an HTML document has started, and then it marks the end of the document. Okay. And some of the important tags which are just included as a part of this, which are included within the HTML tags are tags like get, title, capital letter or a small letter, you can write any one, but as you know that HTML is not sensitive language. It is not a case sensitive language. So you can write either capital or even in the small letters, and it does not change or affect the meaning of the tag. Okay, and then after that you have to end the HTML tag, and for ending any tag we just put the forward slash. To end any tag we used to put a forward tag slash followed by the name of the tag, followed by name of the tag like this. So this is the beginning HTML. Then you will write the other contents or whatever you want to mention within the HTML tag, and then when you want to end the document you have to mention slash HTML. That marks the end of the HTML document. Okay, so the purpose of using the HTML tag was just to mark the beginning of HTML document, and it informs the browser to know that it has, that it is dealing with an HTML document, and it does not impact the appearance of content of the document. It does not have any impact on content of the document. Okay, it is just used for the purpose of marking the beginning and end of the document. The next one is head tag. Another one is the second one. Head tag. Just after the HTML tag, we used to mention, we used to write the head tag, and the head tag defines the document header. It defines the document header and it contains the information about a document, its title and document description. It is a container tag. It is a container tag that is used to define the document header. It generally includes or contains the information about the document, its title, and it includes its title and document description. Head tag. We used to mention the title tag within the head tag itself. And again, the syntax of the head tag is, you will start the head tag, write the description, and then you have to end the head tag with the help of forward slash. Okay? Now, the next one, title tag. Web browser, okay, after finishing or writing the HTML document, and when you will save the document and when you will try to open it in the web browser, it will display whatever you will mention, whatever you have written within the title section. Okay, within this section, whatever you have mentioned or written will be displayed on the title bar of your web browser. So it is known as, it is used to mention the title of the HTML document. Now the next one is body tag. The body tag is the most important tag. It is the most important tag as it contains all the content of the document. The fourth one, the body tag. It is also container tag and one of the most important tag. Or whatever content you want to show it on the web page or on your website. You have finished writing the content. You have to close the body tag using the forward snaps. Like this. You have to close the body tag using the forward slash. And whatever content you have written here or is mentioned will be displayed on the web browser as it is available here in your HTML document. Okay? So, it is one of the most important tag as it contains the content of an HTML document. Now, the another thing is that there are two different categories of HTML elements. There are two different categories of elements in body section. Within the body section, there are two different categories. One is block level elements and another is text level elements. The block level elements are basically are those elements which have been divided into the paragraphs, which are generally divided into the paragraphs or headings or with the horizontal line, which are divided by using the either paragraph tags or heading labels or with the horizontal rule, that is the horizontal line. And the another one is the text level elements. The text level element, they are used for marking up the bits of the text, including inserting image, sounds, etc. Some commonly used text level elements are bold, italic and the line break. You can use the bold, italic, line break, underline. Okay, so these are only used for some of the text, whereas the other, the block level elements, the block level elements are used for the group of the sentence or more than for one sentence. It can be used for a complete sentence or for more than one sentence. Okay, like paragraph tag. If you are want to write the descriptions or the informations on your web page in the form of paragraph, you can use the paragraph tag and you can divide them into different paragraphs, or you can use the different heading labels to display the descriptions on your web page, or even you can use the horizontal lines. You can draw a blank line and separate the two different texts or the sentence or the paragraph. So these are known as the block level elements, whereas the text level elements are generally used for some words or a sentence. Like it is for that particular word or a sentence. Like if you want to make them bold, you can use it italic, underline, or you are using the line break. You want to move to the next line, next new line. So all these are known as the text level element. Okay, now after this, now we will see I will show you that how to create an HTML document. Okay, I will display you how to create an HTML document. For that, first of all, we need to open the notepad, then how to write the program, how to write the HTML document, then how to save it and how to open it in the web browser, or how to view the HTML document in the web browser. Okay, so let's see, and then we will come by this we will come to the end of the chapter, this chapter, and in the next chapter when we will start, we will discuss about some of the more tags. Okay, so now let's see how to open the notepad on our system. Okay, so first of all, you have to, in order to open the notepad or the text, use any text editor. What you have to do is that you have to click on the start button. Okay, after clicking on the start button, the start menu appears on your screen. The start menu appears, and now you have to click on all programs. You have to click on all programs. Now from this list, you go to the accessories. You go to the accessories, and from there, from the accessories, you click on the notepad. You click on the notepad. Clear? Now your notepad is notepad program or the text editor is been opened. on your screen. It is open. Now what you will do, you will start writing the HTML, you will start creating the HTML document, and first of all write the first tag, that is HTML. Okay, now here I am using the small letters only. I am using the small letters. You can use even the small letters or the capital letters, as the HTML is not a case sensitive, it is not a case sensitive language, so you can use as per as your choice. The next tag is head tag. Okay, after the head tag, title tag. Now you have to mention the title of the web, title of the HTML document, which is to be displayed on the title bar. It will be displayed on the title bar. So what you have to do is write the, so suppose we are going to prepare our web page on the topic my family. On the topic my family. Okay. So here I have written the title. Now we need to close the title tag. So use the forward slash and then write title. Now this is how we have completed writing the title. Now we have to end the head tag. Ended the head tag. Now we will start the body tag. This is the body tag. And now we will write the description, or we will write the content of the HTML document which is to be displayed in the information which is to be displayed on the web browser. So here I can write, there are four members in my family. I love them all. We live together and in my family together. Okay. Suppose this is the description you have mentioned. Okay. These are the three sentences or the four sentences I have written. Now I need to close the body tag. So here body. Close the body tag and then come to the end of the HTML document. So we have to end the HTML tag. So the HTML tag, or you can see the HTML tag is mentioned on the top and then in the last. And as we have discussed already, the HTML tag is just used to mark the beginning and the end of the document. Okay. Now this is how we have completed writing the HTML document. We have written the HTML document. Okay. Now how to save it? How to save the document? So in order to save the document, click on the file tab. Click on the file tab and go to the save as option. Open the save as option. Now after opening the save as option, on the left hand side you can select the location. You can select the location where you want to save the document. Okay. So I have choice and then come to the file name. Come to the file name section and here you get the file name. Like suppose I have given the file name family. Okay. Now, as we have discussed already how to save the HTML document, after writing the file name, what we have to do is just you have to mention the file name extension. You have to write the file name extension, that is .html. You have to mention family.html. This is how you can write the complete name of your, give the complete file name, and even you can. Okay. Now you click on the save as, save option. Click on the save option. Now your file has been saved. It is saved. You close the notepad. And now on your desktop, as I have saved the file on desktop, you can see the family file icon is there with name family, and it is showing the icon of your Internet Explorer. Okay, so in order to view the file or to open the file in web browser, what you have to do is that either you can directly right click on this and you can click on the open option. You can select the open option, or you can double click on this and your file will be opened in the web browser. Or another way is that go to the Internet Explorer and then
write all the sentence in the new line. I will write it in
Now you can see we have written all the sentence in the new line, but still it is not displaying in the new line. On the web browser, it is if all the sentences are displayed on the single line itself. So what you have to do that we will use the different tags. Like here now you have to use line break tag. You have to use the br tag. That is the line break tag, and it will display everything. This is how we come to the end of this chapter, and then we will start the next chapter. We will move to the next chapter, so that is chapter 11. We will discuss about some more tags related to the which are generally used in HTML, like paragraph tag, then horizontal group, then line break, how to make the text bold, italic, underline, okay? Then subscript tags, superscript tags will be used. So this is how we come to the end. Then how to apply the background color to your document, HTML document, and how to apply the background image. If you want to apply any background image, use an image as a background, you will use the different tags, and we will create our own web pages. Okay. So this is how we come to the end of the chapter, and I hope that you are able to understand the things HTML. And if you practice more and more at your home, if it is your systems are available at your home, you can practice it by yourself at your home. And if still if you have any doubt or any clarification is needed, you are free to contact me, and I will try to clarify your doubts. Till that time, thank you and have a very nice day.